ma. Tabangin ko sa akong module.
Ay na, mag-deliver para ba kung aning mga inutaw? At to lang sa imong ati patudlo, ha? Basi na kayo nung pa siya ni Ana ang eleksyon.
Dili ang kumusugot nga mapakang ang pagtuon sa atong kabataan. Bisan ubos kita sa pandemya karon, dawata kining gasa sa edukasyon, kinasingkasing ahalad, gikan ning inyong pamunuan.
Gidalik kaninyo ni Mayor Edgardo Labella, Vice Mayor Michael Lopez Rama, ang Chairman sa Committee on Education sa atong konseho, Department of Education, Cebu City Division, Cebu City Local School Board ug Home Radio 106.7, kining Cebu City Educational Laboratory on Radio o Ed Radio. Ed Radio, atong dalit aron mas musayong ang pagkat-on sa atong mga tinunan gamit ang learning modules pinaagi sa pagpaminaw sa ilang mga paboritong teacher broadcasters sa kahanginan. Tune in na sa 106.7 kay matod ni Mayor ang pagkat-on kinahanglan magpadayon.
Luka, anak, andaman nang imuhang module. Ug maminaw na sa Ed Radio, kay magsugod nang imuhang klase.
Yes, pa! Andam na ko! Come on, classmates! Pwede na ba mo sa ito ang klase karon? Maminaw ba ito ang tarong ni teacher, ha? Teacher! Andam na mi!
Everyone, welcome to Ed Radio. This is Teacher MJ for Grade 5 English, Quarter 1, Module 2, and the topic is Vocabulary Building. Again, it's Quarter 1, Module 2. Without much further ado, let's start with the first activity, which is the pretest. Please follow the instructions. Read each question carefully and circle the letter of the correct answer. Write your answers on your answer sheets. Kids, don't forget to submit your answer sheets later to your teacher. Now, let's go to Lesson 1, which is all about words with prefixes. What do you need to know in this lesson? There are two things that serve as your objectives in this lesson. First is decode the meaning of the words with prefixes. And the second one is form new words by adding appropriate prefixes. This time, let's answer the activity under what's in. Please take note of the instructions. Unscramble the letters on the right side of each number to complete the thought of the second sentence. The italicized expressions are clues. Number 1. The princess couldn't decide who to marry. She's still blank. The scrambled word is D-E-D-U-N-C-I-D-E. Again, that's D-E-D-U-N-C-I-D-E. What's the word? Correct answer for number 1 is undecided. Number 2. The prince was not attentive to the princess. The prince was blank. The scrambled word is T-I-V-E-A-T-T-E-N-N. Again, T-I-V-E-A-T-T-E-N-N. The correct answer for number 2 is inattentive. You are correct. Number 3. The curse was quite not possible to solve. It seemed blank. The scrambled word is P-O-S-S-I-M-I-B-L-E. Again, P-O-S-S-I-M-I-B-L-E. The correct answer for number 3 is impossible. Number 4. The queen did not seem to agree with her daughter's plan. She wanted to blank but could not stop her. The scrambled word is R-E-E-A-G-D-I-S. Again, R-E-E-A-G-D-I-S. The answer for number 4 is disagree. Number 5. The prince was not able to satisfy the second witch. The second witch was blank. The scrambled word is F-I-E-D-S-A-T-I-S-D-I-S. Again, F-I-E-D-S-A-T-I-S-D-I-S. The correct answer for number 5 is dissatisfied. Very good. Kids, do you like stories? Alright, let's read a story under What's New. It was Ronelle's 11th birthday. The family was preparing a big celebration for him. While waiting for the guests to arrive, Ronelle went to the park to try out his new bicycle. While there, he met Miss Fortune. Another bicycle bumped him at the rear and Ronelle was thrown out of his seat right into the path of a speeding tricycle. Luckily, the park administrator had taken precautions for such incidents. An announcement was made through the microphone and the first aid attendants came to take him to the first aid station. We found him waiting for us at the anteroom, whiling away his time with a microscope. Ronelle's injuries were not serious and the birthday celebration did not have to be postponed. Now it's time for us to answer the questions about the selection. Number 1. Who was celebrating his 11th birthday? Yes, you're right. Ronelle was celebrating his 11th birthday. Second question. What happened to him when he tried out his new bicycle? Yes, you are correct. He met a misfortune. Another bicycle bumped him at the rear and Ronelle was thrown out of his seat right into the path of a speeding tricycle. Third question. How did the park administrator take precautions for such incidents? The park administrator had taken precautions for such incidents. At this moment, let us go to the content under What Is It? Read italicized words taken from the paragraph. Bicycle, tricycle, microphone, microscope, misfortune, precautions, anteroom. Do you know the syllable or syllables added before each word? What does each syllable mean? How does it affect the meaning of the original word? What do you call these syllables? These syllables come at the beginning of the base word. You probably know by this time that these syllables are prefixes. As you can see from the examples given, you can form new words with prefixes. You can also get the meaning of a word when you know the meaning of the prefix and the base word is familiar to you. The most common prefixes are the following: on, in, this, im, and er are often used to mean opposite of or not. Look at the examples: impatient, illogical, discomfort, immature, irresponsible, illegal, unlike, disappear. These are examples of the common prefixes. We have number, quantity, and time. So, kids, what have you learned in lesson 1? A blank is a syllable or syllables placed at the beginning of the base or root word. What is it? Right, a prefix. A blank is a word that can stand on its own. It cannot be divided into smaller parts and still retain its meaning. What is it? Correct, base word. The meaning of a word can be figured out by putting together the meaning of its prefix and the base word. I think you are now ready to answer the activity under what I can do. Kindly follow the instructions. Match each word with its meaning by writing the letter on the blank or on your answer sheets. Number 1, increase. Increase. Number 2, decrease. Decrease. Number 3, indirect. Indirect. Number 4, redirect. Redirect. Number 5, inflate. Inflate. Number 6, deflate. Deflate. Choices are the following: A, become larger. A, become larger. B, become smaller. B, become smaller. C, direct again. C, direct again. D, not direct. Not direct. E, to let out air. E, to let out air. F, to blow air into. F, to blow air into. What is your answer for number 1? Increase, meaning A, become larger. How about number 2, decrease? Correct. The answer is letter B, become smaller. How about number 3, indirect? The answer is letter D, not direct. How about number 4, redirect means letter C, direct again. Number 5, inflate, meaning to blow air into, letter F. And number 6, deflate, the answer is letter E, to let out air. Very good, grade 5 students! Let's answer test B. Kindly follow the instructions. Use the words with prefixes from exercise A to complete the sentences below. Number 1. When I blank the tire, it will be flat. The correct answer is deflate. When I deflate the tire, it will be flat. Number 2. The price of shirts will blank during the big sale. The correct answer for number 2 is decrease. The price of shirts will decrease during the big sale. Number 3. Here are 20 balloons to blank for the party. Answer for number 3 is inflate. Here are 20 balloons to inflate for the party. Number 4. To make more soup, blank the amount of water. The correct answer for number 4 is increase. To make more soup, increase the amount of water. Number 5. Nick took a blank route to school, so he came late. The answer for number 5 is indirect. Nick took an indirect route to school, so he came late. Number 6. If you are lost, a police officer can blank you to your location. The answer for number 6 is redirect. If you are lost, a police officer can redirect you to your location. Excellent job, grade 5 students! Now let's have another activity under What's More. Please follow the instructions. Add the correct prefix to the words that will make the story complete. The prefixes are on, tele, dis, re, mis. The title of the story is Star Trip. As usual, the little prince of Mars sat in front of the big screen. Blank vision. This life is very blank interesting, he thought. Just then, he heard a knock at the door. A messenger handed him a blank gram. There must be some blank take, said the little prince. But when he opened the envelope, he was surprised. His blank happiness suddenly blank appeared. He was going on a trip to the stars. The little prince was blank certain what to pack. He dashed for his blank scope and magic crystal kit. He packed and blank packed his star travel bag until everything fit. Someday he would blank turn to his own planet. But until then, he was ready for an adventure in the stars. Alright, the first word is television. How about the second word? Correct. Uninteresting. Third word is telegram. Number 4, mistake. Number 5, unhappiness. Number 6, disappeared. Number 7, uncertain. Number 8, telescope. Number 9, unpacked. And number 10, return. Good job, grade 5 students! We are now on lesson 2, which is all about words with suffixes. What do you need to know in this lesson? There are two things that you need to know in this lesson. Number 1 is decode the meaning of words with suffixes. And number 2, form new words by adding correct suffixes. Let's answer the activity under what's in lesson 2. Please take note of the instructions. Write the correct word on the blank to complete each sentence. The words to choose from are the following: preheat, return, underwater, dishonest, misbehave, unwrap, unable, rewrite, unsafe, untied. Number 1. My teacher told me to blank my report. The answer is Rewrite. My teacher told me to rewrite my report. Number 2. Mildred can swim blank for over 1 minute. The answer for number 2 is underwater. Mildred can swim underwater for over 1 minute. Number 3. Our teacher told us not to blank on the field trip. The answer for number 3 is misbehave. Our teacher told us not to misbehave on the field trip. Number 4. Janina almost fell because her shoelaces were blank. The correct answer for number 4 is untied. Janina almost fell because her shoelaces were untied. Number 5. Sherry was being blank when she did not tell the truth. The answer for number 5 is dishonest. Sherry was being dishonest when she did not tell the truth. Number 6. John forgot his backpack and had to blank home to get it. The answer for number 6 is return. John forgot his backpack and had to return home to get it. Number 7. We had to blank the oven before we could put the cookies in. The answer for number 7 is preheat. We had to preheat the oven before we could put the cookies in. Number 8. It is blank to go out without wearing a mask nowadays. The answer for number 8 is unsafe. It is unsafe to go out without wearing a mask nowadays. Number 9. Tony was sad because he was blank to get tickets for the concert. The answer for number 9 is unable. Tony was sad because he was unable to get tickets for the concert. Number 10. Mother said I had to wait until my birthday to blank my gift. The answer for number 10 is unwrap. Mother said I had to wait until my birthday to unwrap my gift. Are you still with me, grade 5 students? That's cool. Now let's go to what's new. Let's read a passage and answer the questions that follow. Ben went on a treasure hunting with his sister Lara to a cave nearby. They brought with them a diary telling that a treasure was hid in there. As they reached the cave's entrance, they saw nothing but darkness. Ben took a step into it bravely, as Lara followed him breathless. They never thought that it might be dangerous in there. Moments later, Ben cried aloud, for he found a small wooden box. Soon, the two opened it with excitement. But to their dismay, they found nothing but letters inside. Feeling tired, they got out of the cave and went home. Let's answer the questions about the passage. First question, who went inside the cave? Yes, Lara and Ben went inside the cave. Second question, why did Ben and Lara went inside the cave? Ben and Lara went inside a cave for a treasure hunting. Third question, what did they find there? They found nothing but letters inside a wooden box. Did you like the passage? Well, now let's go to what is it? Study the words taken from the paragraph. Entrance, breathless, darkness, dangerous, bravely, excitement. What is added at the end of each word? Yes, we have ants, ness, less, O-U-S, ly or li and ment. What do you call these syllables? These syllables are called suffixes. What is a suffix? A suffix is a word part added to the end of a word to change its meaning. It also gives clues to the meaning of words. So, kids, what have you learned in lesson 2? Alright! Suffixes are affixes added after a root word. Suffixes can change the meaning of the words and can be formed into nouns, verbs, adjectives, and adverbs. Try to apply what you have learned. Answer the activity under what I can do. Please follow the instructions. Part A. Add a suffix to the italicized word to form the new word. Number 1. A verb meaning to make simple. The answer is simplify. Number 2. A verb meaning to form crystals. The answer for number 2 is crystallize. Number 3. An adjective meaning without power. The correct answer for number 3 is powerless. Number 4. An adverb that tells how a brave person acts. The answer for number 4 is bravely. Number 5. A noun meaning a person who makes works of arts. The correct answer for number 5 is artist. Very good. Now let's answer part B. Please take note of the instructions. Fill in the blanks with the correct word. For number 1, the words to choose from are lovely, love, lovable. Lila is such a blank child that you cannot help but blank her. She is not blank in looks, but she is kind and cheerful. The correct answers are the following. Lila is such a lovely child that you cannot help but love her. She is not lovable in looks, but she is kind and cheerful. Choice of words for number 2 are the following. Mad, madly, madness. It was a blank dog. Its blank was evident. Its eyes rolled blank around and its mouth foamed with saliva. Correct answers for number 2 are the following. It was a mad dog. Its madness was evident. Its eyes rolled madly around and its mouth foamed with saliva. Kids, are all your answers correct? Wow, that's amazing! Now, let's have another activity under what's more. Please follow the instructions. Add a correct suffix to the italicized item in each sentence. Then write the new word inside the given parentheses or on your answer sheets. Number 1. One that tells lies is a? The answer for number 1 is liar. One that tells lies is a liar. Number 2. It is a place where one lives or resides. The answer for number 2 is residence. Number 3. A holder of a scholarship is a? The answer for number 3 is scholar. A holder of a scholarship is a scholar. Number 4. An expert in geography is a? The correct answer for number 4 is geographer. Number 5. We enter through this door or gate. answer for number 5 is entrance. Number 6, if you lead an orchestra, you are its... The answer for number 6 is conductor. Number 7, a person who always acts on stage is... The correct answer for number 7 is actor. Number 8, a person who climbs mountains is... Mountaineer. That's the answer for number 8. Number 9, one who traps or catches wild animals, it's called a blank. Hunter. That's the correct answer for number 9. Number 10, a person who writes books, poems, or stories is a blank. The correct answer for number 10 is writer. Very good. Now, let's go to lesson 3, which is all about compound words. There are 2 things that you need to know in this lesson, and these are the following. Infer the meaning of compound words through context clues, and recognize compound words and use them in sentences. Before we go any further, let's have a short review about suffixes. Are you ready? Let's do this! This is the activity under What's In of Lesson 3. Number 1. High temperatures will make water blank. The answer for number 1 is vaporize. Number 2. A person who practices the study of nature is a blank. The correct answer for number 2 is naturalist. Number 3. The angry man spoke blank to the telephone operator. Harshly is the answer for number 3. Number 4. Check your spelling for blank when using the new words. The answer for number 4 is correctness. Number 5. The blank football coach made the team run an extra mile. Pitiless is the answer for number 5. Number 6. Before drinking river water, you should blank it because it may be polluted. The correct answer for number 6 is purify. Are all your answers correct? Wow, that's fantastic! At this juncture, let's read the story under What's New. And of course, questions must be answered after reading the story. Marco slung his backpack over his shoulder and ran. The bus company had just introduced a new bus route. Over the cliffs in the distance, Marco could see the sea sparkling. With a smile, he paid for his ticket and sat down. On the driver's lap, there was a newspaper with a bold headline reading, "Burglar Caught." At the back of the bus, a commotion started up with 2 teenage boys arguing. Over the bridge, the bus traveled on until it pulled up at Marco's stop. Below the deep water in the canal, fish swam in the murky depths. Turning down a side alley, Marco reached his front door and took out his key. From the back lawn, the dog was barking a welcome, and Marco was very glad to be home at last. First question about the story. Who was riding on a bus? Yes, you are right. Marco was riding on a bus. Second question, where was he bound for? Right, he is bound for home. Third question, what did he feel having home at last? Correct, Marco felt very glad to be home at last. Kindly turn to What Is It? Read the following words. backpack, newspaper, front door, back lawn, mother-in-law, editor-in-chief. How many words were combined to form new word? What do you call the words with two or more words that are combined to form a new word? How compound words are written in column A and in column B and in column C? Compound words are formed when two or more words are combined to form a new word which may have an entirely different meaning. There are three types of forming compound words. First one is combined or closed, written as one word. For example, flower and pot. When combined, it becomes flower pot. Another is key and board. When combined, it becomes keyboard. Second type is separated or open. These are commonly used together but are written in a space in between. For example, school and bus. It becomes school bus. Living and room becomes living room. The third type is hyphenated. Surprisingly, use a hyphen between two or more words, often to prevent ambiguity. For example, mother-in-law, merry-go-round. Kids, what have you learned in lesson 3? Compound words are words that are combined to form new words and new meanings. Compound words written as one word are called combined or closed. Compound words written as two words are called separated or open. Compound words written with hyphen are called hyphenated. Right now, let's answer what I can do. Please take note of the instructions. Box the correct compound words. Number 1. Air transportation. Airport or airline. Correct. Airline. Number 2. Paper that tells the news. Newscast or newspaper? You're right. Newspaper. Number 3. Ground or place for playing. Playmate or playground? You are correct. Playground. Number 4. Paper with a rough surface. Sandpaper or sandstorm? Yes. Sandpaper. Number 5. A chair with support for the arms. Armband or armchair? You are right. Armchair. Number 6. Having leaves that stay green all year. Evergreen or everlasting? Correct. Evergreen. Number 7. Part of the day between noon and evening. Afterglow or afternoon? You are right. Afternoon. Number 8. Made at home rather than at home or a factory. Homebound or homemade? Right. Homemade. Number 9. A tower with a light that guides ships away from danger. Lighthouse or light bulb? You are correct. Lighthouse. Number 10. A glass container slowly moving sand used for measuring time. Our hand or our glass? You are right. Our glass. Excellent job, grade 5 students. Please go to the activity under What's More. Kindly follow the instructions. Choose the compound word to complete each sentence. The words are the following: living room, wheelchair, sunflower, driveway, basketball, ladybug, weekend. This is for test A. Number 1. James tried out for the blank team. The answer is basketball. James tried out for the basketball team. Number 2. The team had a practice every blank. The answer for number 2 is weekend. The team had a practice every weekend. Number 3. My brother used a blank after he broke his leg. The correct answer for number 3 is Wheelchair. My brother used a wheelchair after he broke his leg. Number 4. A red blank with black dots on it landed on my arm. The correct answer for number 4 is ladybug. A red lady bag with black dots on it landed on my arm. Number 5. My bright yellow blank stood tall in its pot near my window. The correct answer for number 5 is sunflower. My bright yellow sunflower stood tall in its pot near my window. For part B, you have to write a sentence with each compound word given. Then, submit your answer sheets later to your teacher. At this moment, turn to Day 5, Lesson 4, which is all about blended words. Two important things that you need to know in these lessons are the following. Infer the meaning of blended words through context clues. And recognize blended words and use them in sentences. Let's have a review about compound words under what's in. Please take note of the instructions. Write the compound word that is referred to. Number 1. Bell by the door. Correct. Doorbell. Number 2. Cake fried on a pan. Right. Pancake. Number 3. A brush for the hair. Correct. Hairbrush. Number 4. Natural light from the sun. Alright. Sunlight. Number 5. A store that sells medicine. Correct. Drugstore. Number 6. Room where classes are held. Right. Classroom. Number 7. Ache or pain at the back of the body. Correct. Backache. Number 8. Marker placed between the pages of a book. You are correct. Bookmark. Number 9. Used to protect the eyes from the sun's glare. Alright, sunglasses. Number 10. A person who spends much time reading a book. You are right, bookworm. You are doing great, grade 5 students. Keep it up. Please go to What's New and fill in the missing letters to complete the name of each object in the pictures below. Number 1 is email. Number 2, blog. Number 3, emoticon. Number 4, camcorder. And number 5, internet. Very good, grade 5 students. What are the words you have formed? From which words do they come from? How many words does each word composed of? These words consist of two original words whose parts are folded into one, giving a new word and a new meaning. These are called blended words. Blended words are words that are formed by combining two or more words by dropping some letters and producing a new meaning. Sometimes it is called portmanteau words, French word for suitcase. Please study the table that contains most common blended words in English. Kids, what have you learned in Lesson 4? Blended words that are formed by combining two or more words by dropping some letters and producing a new meaning. It is also called portmanteau words, French word for suitcase. Kindly do the activity under What I Can Do. Where do the words come from? Circle the letter of the correct answer. Number 1. Skirt. A. Skirt and shorts. B. Skirt and sports. Correct. Letter A. Skirt and shorts. Number 2. Motel. A. Motto and hotel. B. Motor and hotel. Right, the answer is letter B, motor and hotel. Number 3, staycation. A, stay and vacation. B. Stay and vaccination. Correct. Letter A. Stay and vacation. Number 4. Netizen. A. Internet and citizen. B. Interest and citizen. Correct. It's letter A. Internet and citizen. Number 5. Cyborg. A. Cyber and burglar. B. Cybernetic and organism. Okay, it's letter B. Cybernetic and organism. Number 6. Alphanumeric. A. Alphabet and numeral. B. Alcohol and number. Yes, you are right. Letter A. Alphabet and numeral. Number 7. Telethon. A. Television and marathon. B. Television and cell phone. Yes, it's letter A. Television and marathon. Number 8. Pixel comes from the two words A. Picture and cell. B. Picture and element capital. The answer is letter B. Picture and element capital. Number 9. Simulcast. A. Simulation and broadcast. B. Simultaneous and broadcast. Alright, letter B. Simultaneous and broadcast. Number 10. Sitcom. A. Situation and comedy. B. Situation and communication. Yes, it's letter A. Situation and comedy. Well done, grade 5 students. Please proceed to what's more. Part A. Fill each blank with correct blended words or portmanteau of the given words. Number 1. Use a blank for the noodles. Spoon plus fork. You are right. Spork. Number 2. There are live blank of holy masses during pandemic. Television plus broadcast. Correct. Telecast. Number 3. We used to watch blank competition in the open field near our place. Motor plus cross country. You are right, motocross. Number 4. A good number of blank participated in the recent Clark Field Air Show. Parachute plus troops. Correct. The answer is paratroops. Number 5. The higher the number of blank a camera has, the better quality of picture taken. Picture plus elements. You are right. Pixel. For part B, you have to write the blended form of each pair of words and use it in a sentence. Don't forget to submit your answer sheets to your teacher. Kids, we are on our last lesson, lesson 5, which is all about clipped words. There are two things that you need to know in this lesson. Infer the meaning of blended words through context clues and recognize and use clipped words in sentences. Before we will talk about clipped words, let's have a review about blended words. Write the original words. Number 1. Liger. Yes, lion and tiger. Number 2. Flare. You are right. Flame plus glare. Number 3. Spork. Very good. Spoon plus fork. How about number 4? Motel. Correct. Motor plus hotel. Number 5. Carjack. All right. Car plus hijack. Number 6. Cineplex. Yeah, cinema plus complex. Number 7. Frenemy. Right, friend plus enemy. Number 8. Newscast. Very good. News plus broadcast. Number 9. Workaholic. Alright, work plus alcoholic. Number 10. Guesstimate. Very good. Guess plus estimate. Good job, grade 5 students. Please go to What's New. Read the passage and answer the questions that follow. One fine afternoon, Ed was watching sci-fi movie. While enjoying the movie, he got his juice and burger for snacks from a drive-thru his father got. Just then, mother called him. He went to their bedroom at once, and there he saw mother lying in bed and was not feeling well. Seemed like she was having a flu. Quickly, he got up the phone and called father for help, but of no reached. So, he browsed the internet and searched for some ads about over-the-counter flu medication. Luckily, he found one and rushed to the nearest drugstore to buy some. First question, who was watching the movie? Yes, Ed was watching sci-fi movie. Second question, why did mother call Ed? Mother called Ed because she was not feeling well. Number 3. What did Ed do to help mother? Ed tried to call father, but he can't be reached. So, he browsed the internet and searched for some ads about over-the-counter flu medication. Fourth and last question. What kind of a son was Ed? Ed was thoughtful and quick-witted. Alright, let's proceed to what is it. Read the following sentences below. Number 1. All companies spend a lot of money on ad. Number 2. My phone is ringing. Number 3. I'm having a flu this time. Number 4. Ed likes to watch sci-fi movies. And number 5. Burger is my favorite snacks. What is the underlined word in each sentence? What is the original word of ad, phone, flu, sci-fi, and burger in the sentences? What do you call these words? The underlined words are what we called clipped words. Clipping refers to the reduction of a polysyllabic word by dropping a syllable or more from it. Clipping is also called truncation or shortening. There are 4 types of clipping: back clipping, fore clipping, middle clipping, and complex clipping. Please go to What I Can Do. Always follow the instructions. Write the clipped form of each italicized word. Number 1. Where is grandmother? The answer is grandma. Number 2. What is in your refrigerator? The answer is fridge. Number 3. I can help you do your necktie. The correct answer is tie. Number 4. John likes to do a romantic comedy with Ella. The correct answer is rom-com. Very good. Number 5. My brother plays lawn tennis like a professional. The answer is proof. Number 6. My family want to see the historical movie figure last Saturday. The correct answer is pick. Number 7. A famous company conducted a demonstration on easy car washing. The correct answer is demo. Very good. Number 8. The telephone has undergone a lot of innovations through the years. What is the correct answer? Right, phone. Number 9. Go over the print of your essay and look for typographical errors if there are any. The answer is typo. Alright. Number 10. The earthquake shook buildings and other structures and sent people scampering on the streets. What is the answer? Quake. Very good, grade 5 students. Let's have one more activity under What's More. Part A, give the complete words of the following. Number 1, math. Very good, mathematics. Number 2, bike. Correct, bicycle. Number 3, teen. Very good, teenager. Number 5, lab. Alright, it's laboratory. Number 5, vet. Very good, veterinarian. Number 6, gator. Correct, alligator. Number 7, memo. Correct, memorandum. Number 8, jams. Correct, pajamas. Number 9, forex. Very good, foreign exchange. And number 10, cable. Correct, cablegram. Part B should be done by you. Use the clipped words in sentences. And don't forget to submit your answer sheets to your teacher. My dear grade 5 students, please answer the assessment or post-test. And do not forget to submit your answer sheets to your teacher. This has been Teacher MJ saying thank you for listening.
Luca, anak, kamusta? Humana ba inyo ang klase?
Oo pa! Dagana po niyo mga bagong nakatunan karon. Di ba, classmates?
Wow, very good.
Classmates, magkuyog pi agi hapunta sa sunod na tuong klase, ha? See you!
Maukadto ang atong kinasingkasing nahalad alang sa atong mga tinunan aron ang pagkat-on magpadayon bisan pa man sa mga kabagtuhan nga resulta sa pandemya. Dalit kaninyo sa Cebu City Government Local School Board, Cebu City Council, Department of Education, Cebu City Division ug sa Home Radio 106.7. Atangi ang sunod nga klase sa kahanginan. Hangtod sa sunod higayon, ayaw si Piata sa pagpaminaw sa Ed Radio tungod kay ang pagkat-on kinahanglan magpadayon.